And this is the painting we're gonna make. And we use Millford paper from the St. Cuthbert's mill. And my Maimeriblu pigments. Hello, we're gonna make a painting today. We use some brushes, maybe flat, rounds, rigors, or other rigors, pencil, and watercolor paper is Millford. It's 300 grams, or 140 laps. I recently began painting with Maimeris, and I have to say it's one of the best paints I ever painted with. We do two blues. This is the Ultramarine, blue Ultramarine. This is red, but it is permanent matter. Cobalt blue, light. Watch out, my Maimeriblu got three cobalt blues. And I'm gonna use the light today. I have also the dark. This is the cobalt blue normal. And this is the cobalt blue green blue. But I can use this one, and this is Indian yellow, raw umber, burnt umber. You notice I have no burnt sienna or raw sienna. I make those with these two. A lot. 80% Indian yellow and a bit of madder, and you have raw sienna, a bit of more rather madder, and you have burnt sienna. So that is it. And why? Well, I was a burnt and raw sienna painter. All I did was painting with raw sienna, and burnt sienna. My first go was always those. Okay. Let's make a sketch. For a reeds. Reflections, poles, the houses, some bushes, a little barn. Close by, big one. This also reads wheat. This line is not going to be helpful. And use a kneading gum. It's better for the watercolor paper is very delicate. Let's put it that way. Okay. Gonna make some gray. There's always already some mud on the palette. It's going to be a purple, so a little bit ultramarine and madder. Ultramarine and burnt umber for gray. Gray blue. Little cobalt with it. And then we need some raw sienna. Indian yellow. It's very strong. See this old squeezed out tube paint. And there we have raw sienna. Well, that's it. Now we need a little brush. I tilt the paper with my hand. Now we need some purple. Bit of sienna. Could do with a bit more red. Back to blue. I go over that. Okay, distant trees. We need a cold color that could be a bit stronger. The variation, I add some blue. Has to be blue. Maybe some warmth here. This is burnt umber. A little bit gray already on the palette. Remember, okay, let's look. Bit of stick mix. Work as long as you can in watercolor. Now this is too equal. Okay, drying time. Okay, it's dry. We're gonna make the big tree here, rich. The house is a bit rich, not much really. I'm trying to lose the pencil lines. Okay, three should be do it. The funny brush for the tree. Maybe this one. I don't know. Well. Okay, the tree is somewhere tussen brown and gray. But we make it not one color. We add a little purple too. And this is purple and a little bit of brown. You get a more neutral purple. Okay. Is this dark enough? Not really. Well, that should be do it. Well, could be more. Let's see if the funny brush can do something. I want a really dark purple. We take ultramarine blue, a little bit matter. We get a bit of a 3D feeling here. burnt umber. Ultramarine. Needs a bit cooler, cool gray. The raw umber. Well, we doing the houses. Need a bit darker. Nothing much gonna happen here. Okay, Indian yellow. I'm throwing all sorts of colors. To make it a bit more interesting. But this needs to wet down. This was way too much, how do you call it, attention. Yeah. And on the edge of the paper, so you don't need to look there for me. Okay. I don't know if it's noticeable on camera, but I see it. Okay. Big brush again. Clean water. You can make a warm purple. That red is powerful. Testing. Well, it should be okay. This you have to practice. Need a bit of. Otherwise, I get a how do you call it? Backdrop, backstream, flower quill. It's wet. I don't know if you notice, but the My Miri colors are so beautiful. They give light, and you see every color I make, because they are all single pigment. All colors, almost colors, they have 116, I believe, and 90 from them or more are made of one pigment. So you, every color you make, or is it three or four, it stays beautiful. It never you never get mud. Okay, drying time. Okay, dried. Now we don't need much, maybe a bit of darks underneath. Look for my shines brush. Oh yeah, this burnt umber. Ultramarine. Maybe it's not that dark, but few sticks. Reflection. And some reflection underneath. Here I don't like this very much. Too dark. This could do also with a bit of TLZ. Bit of acrylic. So there's enough. It's a permanent white from Dollarami. So well, I hope you did like it. I did it. I did like it. Thank you for watching. Until next time. All I need to do is sign it. Thank you.